Hello. Today I want to show you how to rhodium plate. Rhodium brush plating. First of all, I always put the gloves on first. I always put gloves on first before I touch anything, really. Even the bottles when they're closed. Hold on. Okay. This is the first what I use, stainless steel plate, which I've got here somewhere. One side is really shiny, the other side is normal rough, or not as shiny, of course. So I use this side, the shiny one. Because I plate rhodium, I will put a thin layer, or a flash basically. Use a tray, I'll use always a tray. Even I have a big tray here. I have another tray which is even longer than this downstairs. Anyway, I use MPU to activate this MPU. Ka-ching. Shake it very well. Then I put it in this thing what I always wash out when I after I used to put a little bit in. I only use a tiny bit. Swap I wash out as well. Right. I don't do the whole lot anyway. I do half or a little bit. Or maybe I do the whole lot. I don't know. Right, okay. Activate the whole lot. Now you can, well, you can use a tissue now, wipe it off, or water. Deionized water. You can see runoff. No water breaks, perfect. So I'll leave it here. Don't leave it longer than, usually start plating straight away. This is what I use. Normally put it in a bag like this because I use them every day. Put it in, hold on. Open it up again. Next time I use it because I have a sealer here anyway. So I can seal. You know, seal the bag, which I always do when I, which one I use. There's solution still left, so I'll show you now without using any solution, only the solution what is left basically here in the swap. Right, I switch this on now, which I use this. It's plugged in somewhere down there. Saves me to go around there. 5.7 is fine at the moment. I'll leave it like this. Right, this will plate now slower than usual, of course. But anyway, I only want to put the thin layer on anyway. That's it. And I don't care if it scratches here or not. It's only for an example anyway. So, thin layer, ka-ching, job done. Now I'll put this away again. I usually normally seal it now, but I've done it a few times, so now I need a new bag. Anyway, so rinse this one. Very well. Hold on. Make sure you rinse your gloves. I think it's very important because, especially when you do gold, silver contamination, because with silver is quite. If you have contamination with silver, sometimes you don't even know what the hell went on, why it doesn't it play very well. Sorry. So now I use ka-ching, dry it a little bit, but you don't need to do this really. Put it here on side. I've got it here now, so here on side. This one I rinse. Right, now I use the rhodium. Where's the bloody rhodium? Here. I use a different tray. This is bloody dirty, but it doesn't matter. I'll chuck it away anyway afterwards. Use rhodium. This is the rhodium. Is there anything in there? 5 to 7 volts. So I'll leave it at 5.7. I'll need a beaker. Here's a beaker. A brand new beaker. Put a little bit in there. Tiny bit. Rhodium is quite expensive. It's a bit like gold price roughly at the moment. And it's a yellow color. It's a yellowish color. Right. Now I use, well, you can use platinum electrode. I use, in this case, carbon. You can get them in my shop. Use a brand new swap. Don't even know what swap I'm using. I use, anyway, swaps you can get in my eBay shop as well. I use this swap. You can get them from spar plating. It's a mini, tiny swap. So you need to wet them before. Quite well, otherwise you will have problems. I wet them and rinse them out, you know, squeeze them a little bit, get the water out as good as possible. Now they're a little bit wet, especially when the swap is brand new. Even they're very thin. Oh, bloody hell, I can't get it on. Yeah, to get it on is sometimes freaky. It's easier if you have a, oh, hold on. Turn the handle a little bit, the electrode, ka-ching, is on. Right, and also, I never put this in there, the crocodile clipper, always make sure you rinse the crocodile clip, especially with rhodium. You must be careful with rhodium. So now I soak it very well, because I don't put any, I don't put a lot in. Look, I soak it very well. You need to soak it very well, otherwise no conductivity, especially this swap. The other swap would be easier. You don't need to soak it so much, so long. But this swap, especially, has never been used. It takes a while. Right. Do I need to activate? Not really. But I do it anyway. I do a little bit of clean again. And this time I wipe it. I wipe it dry as well. Ka-ching. Put a clip on, which I already, or you can put the clip basically if you don't want a scratch on the back. I would put it normally on the back. If this would be an item what I played for someone, I would put it on the back because I don't play the back. I wouldn't do it like this because you have fine scratches. Even rhodium, when the rhodium is played, rhodium is very hard. Rhodium, you need only a very, very thin layer. Rhodium, hold on. Rhodium, I'm just looking how hard rhodium is. Rhodium 1246, 1060 is chrome, so it's quite a bit harder than chrome. So now I have the settings. So first of all, I'll do this. Thing is moving, can you see this there? Yeah. So there is a contact, hold on. Right. So this works. And now I'll watch the meter anyway, if there's anything going on. Oh yeah, I can see it anyway. I can see it straight away. Look, I don't even need to do anything really. I don't even need to watch there. So rhodium is on. Look, the little plaque, you can turn it down a bit. If you turn it down a bit, it will not be so bad with the marks there. You can see there's small marks on there. There, plaque. It tarnish a little bit. You can see there. It's nothing to worry about. You can polish it out there, there as well. Okay. Rhodium is extremely hard, as I just said. So you need only a very thin layer. You can see the rhodium is already out of the swab. Soak it again. I always do the corners as well, which many people don't even do here. I mean, you don't really, well, I do it always like this. So I'm only concentrating mainly on this area here, the bottom one. Now it looks basically very close to the stainless, polished stainless steel what it was before. It's not much different really, unless you put it next to each other, you see the difference. So pull it over, current is going through, so okay, leave it. This is how it looks like, not perfect. Wash it, I mean rinse it, put it on side here, rinse my gloves as well, and the crocker. Crocker clip is always very important, so don't put it back on the same where I clipped it earlier. So now, where are we? Here. This is stainless steel side, this is the rhodium side. Now I can polish it with MPU, what I used for activating and cleaning before. Because rhodium is so bloody hard, it will, to remove the rhodium now, Golda would be already took a little, would have already take a little bit off, I guess. That's it. Right, this is the rhodium now plated, so it's not much different to a normal, hold on. Well, wow, hardly any different really. This is the rhodium, this is the stainless steel. There is not much different really. So what's the point of rhodium? I don't know. No. Rhodium, well, good question, but very hard rhodium. So you need only 0.1, 0.2 microns of a layer. A ringer would play it maybe 0.4, 0.5, and this lasts forever, basically. If you played gold, a ring with gold, which is like 200 something hardness, Vickers hardness, you need like more like 2.5 microns, 3 microns. Rhodium is so hard, yeah, it's harder than chrome, so you need only a thin layer. But it looks alright, looks alright. It's the other side, the original. So I put a gold flash on first. Gold flash, because you can't play it directly onto stainless steel, will not stick very well, not go on at all. And yeah, I play the gold flash, thin layer of gold, and then put rhodium on. Okay, thanks for watching, and till next time, please subscribe and thumbs up. Leave comments if you want, and if you want any solution, this rhodium I don't sell on the eBay shop or my own shop. You need to go to Sparplating directly. And most many stuff I sell on my eBay shop, gold and silver 01 or goldensolution.co.uk is no S on the end, golden solution. Thanks for watching. Till next time, goodbye.